fall. It's all about the leaves changing. Pumpkins everywhere. Even in my coffee. Pumpkin spice latte. But I live in LA and tomorrow's gonna be 86 degrees. So my pumpkin spice latte is gonna be on ice. Hey guys, my name's Ray Pahar and welcome to Get Crafty Crafty. Today, I'm gonna show you guys how to make a weaving tree. This is a fun project that you guys can do either if you're a teacher in the classroom or you're a parent or a babysitter. This is a great thing that you can do that teaches kids how to create a blended background, and it also teaches them how to do a basic weave for a fall tree. Let's go ahead and get started with today's project. The items that you'll need for today's project include brown yarn, colored yarn for your leaves. Today, I'm using a green fringe, some acrylic paint, paintbrushes, scissors, and two heavy-duty paper plates. First, you're gonna create the background for your plate. You could either apply the paint right onto your plate, or you could put it aside and just apply it on separately. Use your brush to blend your two colors together. I usually put a little bit on the bottom and then apply some to the middle and then start to blend the top into the bottom. Once you have a good amount of it spread out, you'll be able to get an idea of how much you actually need to blend. After your paint has dried, you're gonna then take your plate and attach it right on top of another plate just so that it's a little bit more sturdy for this project. I'm gonna use this brown marker to show you guys where you're gonna create your inserts. You wanna have two cuts at the bottom for the base of your plate. And then you wanna have either 5 or 7 cuts at the top for the rest of your plate. Space them out about 1 inch or so apart. The cuts on your inserts should only be about 1/2 inch into your plate. They really should just be on the rim and shouldn't go into your actual design. Next, you're gonna apply your yarn to your tree. Take your yarn and on the far left side, you're gonna just slide it right in and have about 2 or 3 inches of yarn in the back. Take this piece and then connect it to the bottom left insert. Roll it over and push it through the top insert and then bring it up to the next insert. Put it through, guide it along, go through the next insert, and then bring it back down to your bottom left. Repeat this over until you've gone through all of your inserts and your tree has started to grow. When you're threading your yarn for your tree, you want to make the far left and the far right branches a little bit more loose compared to the rest of the tree. Mainly because when you actually create the bark, these two branches are going to be pulled a little bit more compared to the rest of your tree. Once you've created your branches, what you're going to do next is take the first thread and you're just going to tie it right in the back so that your tree doesn't fall apart. Just create a small knot. Want to create the trunk of your tree, what you're going to do is you're going to wrap the yarn around your tree so that it is going to be looping over and over. Take one side, loop it under, and then you're just going to take your ball of yarn and you're going to pull it right through that loop. Gently pull it so that it creates a little loop. You're gonna do this multiple times until you have enough for your trunk. Under, and then through. It's gonna be a little hard to see at first, but once you have enough yarn going through your trunk, you'll be able to see it form. Once you've created a good amount of your trunk, all you're gonna do is cut your string and then just loop it around your first branch and then make another knot. Loop it around, make a knot, and then it should seal your tree. You could even do a second knot if you feel like you need to. To create the leaves for your tree, what you're gonna do is take about 2 to 4 feet of yarn and you're just gonna wrap it around something small like a post-it. The reason you wanna separate it from the ball of yarn is mainly because it's gonna be a little hard to actually weave the entire ball of yarn over and under your little leaves. So, by doing this, you'll have a better range of control of how to actually apply it. Take your leafy yarn and all you do is attach it onto your first branch, make a little knot, and then all you're going to do is go over and under each branch in an alternating motion. Over, under, over, under, over, under. And then repeat the same process going back the other way. It's gonna take a good amount of time to get this done. But as you're doing this, go ahead, gently pull on your yarn and then just push the tree, the leaves of the tree, a little down as you're going through. Over and under, over and under, over and under, over and under. Keep going until you've filled up a good amount of your branches. Once you've gone through all your yarn to attach more, all you have to do is take the two pieces together and then just tie them together. Tie it up, and you can continue weaving your tree. Over and under, until you've used up all of your second part of your yarn. Once you've gone to the upper branches of your tree, what you can do is skip the far left and far right branches. This way, you'll be able to continue weaving and you'll be able to add a little bit more leaves to the top of your branch. This will also give it a little bit more character and not have your tree look like a triangle. Do this until you have enough leaves. Depending on what kind of yarn you use for your tree will really show what kind of foliage you guys have on your tree. Because I used a green fringe, it definitely looks like it's a very healthy tree that hasn't gone through the seasonal change yet. Once you're done with this project, go ahead, hang it around your classroom, your living room, your fridge, and celebrate the start of autumn. Definitely one of my favorite seasons, even though I can't really tell that it's autumn in LA since it's 86 degrees. Good thing I have my pumpkin spice latte. Thanks again for watching Get Crafty Crafty. Come back next time to see what fun projects we're gonna make. Make sure you check out our last two videos, the candy pencil case and the cardboard claws. Thanks again for watching and take care.